Fellow citizens, once again, we join with nations across the globe in solidarity to observe International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women. It is not only a day of reflection, but a call to action and a call for unity. A call for unity and action in the face of a pervasive issue that continues to cast a dark shadow over the lives of countless women and girls worldwide. Let us be mindful that what we do today, we must do the same tomorrow and the day after that and the day after that to galvanize support to end all forms of violence against women and children. We must be committed to sustain our efforts. Let it become a daily habit. Let us collectively and as individuals resolve to do something to help prevent violence against women and girls. Fellow Trimbegonians, as it pertains to human rights violations, the United Nations notes that violence against women and girls continues to be one of the most widespread, persistent, and devastating human rights violations in the world today. Unfortunately, evidence of this exists in Trinidad and Tobago. My fellow citizens, despite all the efforts being made by government, civil society organizations, regional and international bodies, private citizens, and corporate bodies, violence against women and girls continues to be a major concern in Trinidad and Tobago. According to the Crime and Problem Analysis Branch of the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, there was an overall increase of 42% in the number of domestic violence cases reported in Trinidad and Tobago over the period 2021 to 2023. In 2023 alone, up to September, 1,968 cases of domestic violence were reported to CAPA. The data indisputably reveals a disproportionate impact on women and girls, particularly those aged 15 to 35, highlighting the youthful nature of this phenomenon. Violence against women is not merely an isolated incident. It ripples through families, leaving a trail of destruction in its wake. As we address this grave issue, we must acknowledge the profound negative impact it inflicts upon families and, most distressingly, upon innocent children who bear witness to such acts. Studies have indicated that children who witnessed violence committed against one of their parents are at a higher risk of developing behavioral problems in the future. Such children are likely to have higher hostility, anger, anxiety, and mental health issues that can significantly influence their adulthood. Research also suggests that domestic abuse is a learned behavior and therefore paves the way for a cycle of violence. As they grow into adults, it becomes an accepted reality to either accept being a victim or a perpetrator. The domino effects of domestic violence permeate generations without discrimination, altering the fabric of our society. For women and girls who are disproportionately impacted by violence, their freedom of movement is restricted out of fear of further abusive episodes by their perpetrators. This affects various facets of women's lives, influencing decisions related to finances, reproductive and sexual health, educational pursuits, participation in the workforce, and the enjoyment of associated benefits. Furthermore, it restricts their freedom to access adequate healthcare, housing, and proper nutrition, all of which ultimately impact their ability to care for themselves and their children. It is essential to recognize that violence against women and girls is preventable. It requires an all-of-society approach that involves partnerships between government agencies, civil society organizations, the private sector, individuals, families, and communities. Let us come out of the, you know, I used to hear and see syndrome that is so common after it is too late when a life is lost. when a child is harmed, when a family is destroyed, and when the hearts of a community starts to bleed because it could have been prevented. In Trinidad and Tobago, we continue to make strides towards the development of a zero-tolerance attitude towards violence against women and girls through the work of government and our partners. The various activities and interventions through the Spotlight Initiative has had a wide reach across sectors, including the judiciary and the police service, facilitating capacity building and enabling institutional strengthening. A significant output is the National Strategic Action Plan on Gender-Based Violence and Sexual Violence 2023-2027, which has been accepted by Cabinet for implementation. As I close, I want to appeal to all in this Twin Islands state. Take a stand. Make a commitment to stand strong and stand in solidarity with all women and girls. Let us end all forms of violence against women and girls in our lifetime.